Hello guys, feel warmly welcome to Usitility. Do you know what? We're on the way to see how to launch and play Ragnarok X Next Generation on your PC. As you can see now, you can watch it on screen. It will be possible to efficiently download and install Ragnarok X Next Generation and enjoy the game on our Windows computer with gamer keyboard if we want to, mouse and large monitor. Then without further ado, let's go. First of all my friends, the first thing to do is to launch our favorite internet browser. We open the one we use by default. Let's go to the current URL I have highlighted in green color. There you are seeing it on the PC screen. There is no need to type it because there's a link in the description of this video and the first pinned comment. We arrived on this page on our own site of Usitility, in which we have a nice meticulous demonstration on the best way to obtain Ragnarok X Next Generation on computer. We browse lower a tad and then click on the Download Game on PC button. Once clicking on that link, we arrive here on the site of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we will run to enjoy the game Ragnarok X Next Generation on the PC. As you can see here, we access some advantages of preferring this emulator. Then, we are on the way to start downloading the Ragnarok X Next Generation by simply clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that I have marked in green color. We then click on the button. And the download step takes no time at all. Voila, here is located the download. It's a file we have to execute. The following step is to run the executable file, okay, then we click on this file. If we are on Windows 10, it will have asked us for permission to allow modifications to the laptop or device. We answered yes. I reduce the web browser to start to see the installation software better. The installer is very easy to use. It is made up of a couple of choices, install, and setup path. I am going to make it clear what setup path genuinely does. We basically just click it. And now we discover that we display here the path where the emulator is going to be put in. If we are planning to change for better this folder, we need to click on this browse option, and now we select another folder and install the emulator exactly where we would like. To keep it simple, just leave it as it is. Then, I click on back. So I pick install. Voila! The install commences and it is going to carry on together with the download of all these MB that happens to be shown on that computer screen. Once you download it, it is likely to be a little more or less megabytes. The data transfer speed might go faster or slower, depending on your type of connection and according to the efficiency of the emulator servers. Now they're progressing really fast. The download has been completed, so straight away it continues on with the setup step. The setup requires a little bit more or less time according to the power of your machine. The more powerful it really is, the faster the setup time and or vice versa. If we merge the download and setup phase, it usually takes quite a long time, so show patience. It is now finished for me. At this moment, the emulator has actually been started successfully. As you can observe, at the bottom of the screen, we have a progress bar which will move forward to the right when it has reached the ending. The emulator is launched for the very first time. The truth is the emulator is already started there for the first time. Before we carry on, as can be seen, it created a couple of software icons right here on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks multi-instance. Note that the BlueStacks app icon is going to be the one we are concerned about. When we choose to launch Ragnarok X Next Generation on our desktop or laptop, we double-click on this software icon and use the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon isn't related to multiplayer or even anything at all such as that. Not surprisingly, it's an app icon that we may certainly never utilize. Why don't we make the next phase, which is actually a requirement, and that's to visit the Google Play Store. As you can observe, the Google Play is presented. In this case, we are required to log on. At this time, the moment we're on this page, we have to begin doing this next phase that is definitely obligatory. Therefore, we mouse click on Sign In. At this moment it announces checking info. It might once in a while get blocked in checking info, and so it fails to continue. If that's the case, you should attempt to connect to your account after a couple of hours, but it will surely usually be sorted out. At this moment we shall type our email address and password. The email really needs to be a Gmail email as well as its related password. For instance, you make use of the exact same email address you're using at this time in your YouTube account. Therefore I am going to enter my information and I will revisit after I have accomplished it. That's all, information typed. Discover Google welcoming us and supplying us the twos. We must say yes to all of them simply by clicking I agree. Following, it allow us to backup to the Google Cloud. You can also let it checked and this will generate a backup of the files on that device to Google Drive. I will not select it, you can utilize this option if you like. We click accept. Google Play Store is started without need to open it manually and completely on its own. To set up the app, we would need to get to the emulator desktop for Android by left-clicking that app icon marked green-colored. Today that we are exploring the desktop of that emulator for Android, we notice that we come with there the install app game option. We mouse-click on that button. Right here we access to the Android game. Let's simply click there on the install choice that I'm just presenting now in green. Therefore it will initiate the software setup. Straight away it would download and install the Android game, it typically takes some time or it may possibly be extremely fast. This all is dependent upon on the web connection. It has actually finished installing. Back to the emulator desktop by simply clicking on the following option that I'm presenting in green, if you want to use Ragnarok X Next Generation for the very first time. Let me press on this my game's choice proceeding. We're at present on the emulator desktop and as a consequence we're preparing to mouse click on the fresh Ragnarok X Next Generation software icon that's been generated. This Android game is started for the first time on your computer. Now there we get it, I am able to mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I should talk about the sound level of that emulator. It's here. We use the icon of higher volume along with the icon of lower volume, this manner we won't rely on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the sound of this emulator. As well as to appreciate the experience to the greatest, we will switch on the big screen, for which we have two alternatives. That is simply the very first one, we then click on this particular software icon which I am basically designating in green. Then the display screen is maximized, enjoying one border on top, one on the right side and the third one at the bottom. Assuming that we like to launch the application using all the screen, we hit that software icon. And we might without a doubt be experiencing and enjoying the game app in full screen function. To stop the complete screen setting, click the F11 key. And we just play in regular computer screen setting. At this moment I am ready to clarify you the computer keys mapping that is really surprisingly cool. That means we may be ready to utilize the video game a lot more easily. The very first thing is to click this keyboard icon. And here you will have the ability to complete the recommended configuration settings. I'm going to let the normal settings, however if you choose to improve it, you can also do so with no problem. Clearly, the emulator is absolutely in our own language. Once in a while it occurs that the emulator is presented in the erroneous language, such as, in Chinese language. And therefore to set it up in the appropriate language we browse here to the cogwheel. Then right here throughout many other options, we just click on the language drop down. We are able to go with the language we need, Spanish, Japanese, and so forth. When the language is selected, we could save, the emulator would restart, along with the video game, the next time we run it, would of course be in the picked language. At this point, you will find another point that we have to take into consideration, and it's that we will get an email telling you that a brand new machine has been connected with our Google account. It is going to check with us if we are the people who have connected that device. Yes, we must not worry, simply because the emulator is acting as an Google Android device. In order to identify which tablet or smartphone is currently being emulated, we go here, to the cogwheel and we mouse click on it. And so we browse here to the model selection. And now we determine that the emulator is acting as a Samsung smartphone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all guys, so much for my video user demo. I anticipate you enjoyed it, especially that everyone thought it was helpful. In that case, bring it a great like, subscribe, and if you have remarks, concerns or suggestions, leave them in the comment field below. You can even comment things on my Twitch channel, I conduct live streams every once in a while, you have it listed below in the video description and in the initial pinned comment. Simply click any of those instructional videos that are appearing on the computer screen and let's have fun again in the future training videos. Bye.